All right, so here's some highlights from the game for those of you that weren't able to travel to Williamstown. I'm going to kind of do these highlights in chronological order because I wanted those who weren't there to see. I thought it's important to see how we started the game. And we, you know, one of the things I was most impressed with is we executed in all three phases. This is the opening kickoff, and they kind of get a wobbly kick here. But I want you to watch a couple things here. Start with Jamie Law, one of our sophomores. He was our special teams player of the game in this game. And if you watch his block on this opening kickoff, you'll see, you know, some physical play that started us off here. And so that was the first thing that I noticed here. Great, great block here by sophomore Yosa Nosemief. And the other thing here is Darian Myers to picking up this bad hop. And unfortunately, you don't get the lead block because of the bad hop. Ian's kind of, Duggar's waiting for the to see where the ball goes. But Darian, as you, we try to get our kick returners to do, just hits it. And in some ways, you know, just outruns some of the coverage. And we get the ball across the 40-yard line, which is a good field position to start. Then, as I mentioned a couple of times, I thought our offensive staff did a great job of game planning. I thought we really kept a mixture of who was going to have the ball in their hands and the run and pass. And first play of the game here, we're going to throw a three-step kind of a route. We've got Mike Budness in the flat and Chudy in the flat. Henry hits Chudy to the field here. Nice gain just to get us going. Gets us across the 50. Very next play, we're in the no huddle here, and we're going to hand the ball to Chudy on an outside zone play into the boundary, which is well blocked at the point of attack, and then Chudy makes one guy miss, gets us an extra 9 or 10 yards. And then in this same first drive, we put freshman quarterback Spencer Aucamp into the game here. Completely different formation than we've shown with the three-back set. And you'll see a very well-blocked play. We get good movement here from Joe Magardino and Josh Golden, and a double team here from Connor Flynn and Will Linner. And this action kind of draws a little bit of the defense wide. And then you get a good jump cut in the hole by Chudy off of that block there. And it just, we were going this first drive, 6-7 yards a clip, kind of going no huddle, keeping them off balance. Here's a third down play in the red zone. And we're going to throw the ball to Ian Duggar here in the boundary on a hitch. Simple play, but, you know, it's not something you always execute correctly. Henry gets rid of the ball real well, hits Ian right on the outside shoulder, and then Ian makes the corner miss, picks up an extra 7 yards. So that led to our first touchdown. So, and then our kickoff team goes on the field right after that touchdown, and you're going to see a couple things here. You're going to see we're getting great effort down the field. Here's Jamie Law, who I had mentioned before, is going to get all the way down and kind of disrupt things. We've got freshman here, Johnny Medina, freshman safety, way down ahead of everybody. And those guys are going to kind of squeeze to the ball. And then you're going to see sophomore Kevin Martin, a fold player, come in here and make a big hit. And again, just setting the tone for the game right off the bat with that opening drive, and then our kickoff team keeping them down inside the 20 to start. And now this is that first drive, and we kind of anticipated some sprint from Williams here, and we rolled our coverage to try to take away the quick throw on a third down play. And I want you to watch Lyle Baker from the opposite three technique come all the way down the field and get the quarterback there and get a drive stop for us, big play. So now this is our punt return team goes on the field after what we've just seen from our other two special teams and our offense and defense, and we really execute a return that we have set up well. We're mugging people at the line of scrimmage here, trying to, you know, I think we've got some dynamic guys with the ball, so we're trying to set up some returns. We've got sophomore Gus Ackley back here, fields the ball, and we set up some real good blocks. Senior Joe Diaz, this is a drill we work all the time on making sure we don't block in the back. It's called the shield drill. Joe does a great job. And then look at the leverage that we have here on all these blocks. First from Will Herbert, who did a great job in all our special teams. Then PJ Dorsey comes in, great leverage on his block. And then here comes Jamie Law on the wall right there. And Gus, this is a 33-yard return. which sets up our second drive on offense. So we were really, you know, guys came out firing at all cylinders early on. Here's Darian Myers on a jet sweep. Again, going back to that theory of trying to get the ball to different players. Darian's pretty dynamic with the ball in his hands. And this is well blocked on the edge. We get a good cut block from Michael Budness right here. But Darian's, you know, runs the ladder real well. That's a big play. Gets us down inside the red zone. And now on a third down play, we're going to drop back to pass, run a little post here, and send Chudy on a wheel route. It's actually pretty well covered by the Will linebacker. But Henry steps up in the pocket, throws a good ball, and Chudy makes a nice catch. And this comes back down to just execution. You know, I thought the defense played that play well, but that's a big, big score on a third down play to make it 14-0. Defensively, I wanted to highlight a couple of guys. Tom Szymanski, our senior outside linebacker, played extremely well in this game. A couple plays here. This is a screen pass, not an easy one to defend because clearly they've got guys to block them, and they're getting their ball to their very good tailback here coming out of the backfield. But Tom plays with his hands really well, plays off the block, and is there to make the tackle. But the other thing that really impressed me about our defense is look at all the white jerseys running to the ball. And we had a lot of people around the football on this day. Here's going to be a different kind of screen pass. They're going to throw a screen out here, and Tom's going to read the screen. He actually doesn't make the tackle, but by reacting to the screen and making the ball carrier bounce sideways, he allows all his help from everybody else on the defense with that great effort that we talked about. So this is something we talk with our defense all the time. You don't have to be the guy that makes the play. But if you know where you fit and you do it full speed and we get everybody else running to the ball, you usually play some pretty good defense. Okay, going back, in the first game, we put Spencer on the field a couple of times and called his number and against Colby. And he didn't always hit the hole where it belonged. We called it up to the first game jitters as a freshman. He did a much, much better job in this game. You can see earlier in the game, we'd hit Chudy inside on a couple of run plays out of the set, and then this time Spencer's going to keep the ball. And what I liked about what he did here is he takes it up inside the block. And he did that a couple of times in this game, and I thought it kept the defense off balance. This is a third and long play right here. Talked about getting the ball to some different people. You're going to see in third and long, we thought we had some one-on-one coverage out here on the corner, so we're going to double move with our receivers and try to get to the top field shoulder. I think both receivers did a good job on this move. Henry went to the field and hit Ian Duggar, and that was a big play for us. This is on our third drive. That led to another score. This is a big turnover for us on defense. Going back to very similar to what we did against Colby. We four-man rushed a lot in this game. You're going to see sophomore nose guard Matt DeAndrea win this one-on-one matchup and get some pressure on the quarterback. I thought we did a really good job in the D-line. We had their quarterback going backwards and throwing off his heels a lot, and that allowed some errant throws, and this one ended up in Spencer Donahue's hands. Okay, back on offense here, talking about getting some different guys the ball, and this just comes down to, I think we have some dynamic playmakers. This is a tough play on third down. Bubble throw to Darian Myers, which wasn't the prettiest throw, but not only does Darian make the catch, he breaks a tackle and turns it into a 23-yard gain. So a lot of explosive plays out of our offense in this game. Again, going back to getting the ball to somebody different, here's a Nick Gaynor, a sophomore, played a lot of running back in high school. So as a receiver for us, we got to get him the ball in his hands. He does a really good job, and you're going to see him make a big play here, and great effort at the end of the play, carrying some Williams guys and just keep driving those legs. Here's a third down play, same drive where we're going to run a three-step and hit Chris Ragone, our senior receiver here, on a slant. Chris does a great job with the route. But again, if you watch Henry's release, Henry does a really nice job of taking the snap and getting rid of the ball quickly. It's tough to defend that. That led to a field goal to get us up 17-0. Another guy we wanted to highlight on defense based on his performance, Joe Diaz was our defensive player of the game, senior cornerback. He had 9+ plays in this game, which is the way we grade our defensive players if they've done something extra on a play. Like here, right here, he's isolated on a post, and he's in great position on the post. Nice pass breakup. Here's a fourth down play, and they're going to try to run a three-step slant on Joe. He's going to break on the ball real well and get his upfield hand on the ball, get a drive stop here. And Joe just played an outstanding football game for us. This was, you know, Chudy had 4 touchdowns in the game. He actually had 5 touchdowns. One of them was called back from an illegal shift. So it would have been 5 touchdowns for him. But if you watch what Chudy's doing really well, is he's hitting the hole where the play is designed. But let's give some credit to the guys blocking the play as well. We're going to see Will Linner here making a really good block. Senior tight end Brendan Oliver is playing exceptionally well right now in his role. He's going to come out here and seal the edge. And then Mike Budness, our senior fullback, is going to wrap around. And this play is blocked. I mean, Josh Golden's got the kick-out block. Brendan's got the seal block. Here comes Linner on the block down. And, you know, just really well blocked play. Chudy ran it in there. That was his 4th touchdown of the game. And it was nice. You don't usually get to do this in a Williams game. I've been involved in 17 Trinity Williams games as a player and coach, and never seen anything quite like what we were able to accomplish yesterday. Just, we were able to play our young guys the entire 4th quarter. And you're going to see freshman linebacker Colin Geyer do a great job loading on the quarterback here, which causes an errant throw, which is picked off by P.J. Dorsey. And it was nice to see our young players go out and execute. Sometimes you get in those situations and they don't, you know, they're not ready to get it done, but they really executed. Here's on offense a good example. Hayden Jardine, our backup quarterback right now, who's actually had a great preseason. He's going to run a read play here with freshman running back Ethan Sirachi. And Ethan's going to be a really dynamic player here. He's a downhill physical runner, but he's also got some speed. As you can see here, he takes it to the edge and almost gets in the end zone. This was right at the end of the 3rd quarter, and Ethan actually 2 plays later ended up scoring in the 4th quarter. So real fun day for the Trinity Bantams, and hopefully we can keep our guys rolling.